The most common question about Oracle Enterprise Manager, which has been asked to me, is I forgot to copy the URL of the Oracle Enterprise Manager at the end of the installation of the Oracle database. What should I do now? Today, let's answer it once and for all. What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Welcome to the first video of the Oracle Enterprise Manager series. Today we will be talking about the URL of Oracle Enterprise Manager Database Express or OEM Express. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. Before we jump ahead, let me quickly brief you about the database configuration which I will be using in this demonstration. I'm using Oracle Database 19c Enterprise Edition, which is the latest offering from the Oracle. I have done its installation video, which you can check out here. Also, in my Oracle database, I have just one root container and one pluggable database. The name of the root container database is cdb$root and the name of the pluggable database is orclpdb. Anyways, though I am using Oracle Database 19c here, but these steps also apply for Oracle 12c and Oracle 18c as the process is the same. So this is my setup. Now let's move on to the Oracle EM. As we know that Oracle Enterprise Manager is a web-based database management tool. Thus, in order to access it, we need an URL. This URL is made up of two parts, the domain name and the port number. Domain name is either the IP address or the name of the computer over which you have installed and configured your database server. If you have configured your Oracle database server on your local machine, then this will be localhost. For this demonstration, I have installed my Oracle 19c on my laptop. Thus, in my case, the domain name will be localhost. Now, let's come to the port number. By default, Oracle installer sets the port number 5500 for your Oracle Enterprise Manager. Yes, 5500 is the default port number for the Oracle Enterprise Manager. So the default URL of the Oracle Enterprise Manager will be this. If for some reason this does not work for you, then that means the problem is either with the domain name or with the port number. We will come to the domain name later. Let's first see how to find out the port number for your Oracle Enterprise Manager. We can find the port number using getHttpsPort function. This function is defined inside the dbms_xdb_config package. It returns HTTPS port number for the container into which you have called this function. Let me show you how. Let's open up the command prompt and connect with the database. Now I am connected to my database using this sysuser. Let's check. But first, let's clear the screen. Done. Now let's check the user. The user is sys. Let's also check the container through which we are connected to the database right now. Container name is cdb$root, which means we are connected to the root container using the sys user. Next, we have to call the getHttpsPort function to find out the port number. As this function is defined inside the dbms_xdb_config package, thus we will be using the dot notation to call it, which means we will first write the name of the package dbms_xdb_config followed by a dot and the name of the function, which is getHttpsPort, and we will be calling this function through the select statement like this. Dual is a dummy table which Oracle creates while configuring the database. Let's execute this statement and see what the result is. As you can see, the result is 5500, which means for my root container, the port number of the Oracle EM is 5500. In simple words, if we will use this port number 5500, then Oracle server will log us on the Oracle EM through our root container cdb$root. Let's check.
don't worry about this warning. Just click advanced and then proceed to localhost. I'm using the sys user to log in into the EM. Of course, the username will be sys. I have set Oracle as the password for my sys user during the installation. This could be different in your case. For the time being, leave the container name field empty. Now hit the login button. There you go. That is how we can find out the port number for the Oracle Enterprise Manager. Now let's come to the domain name. But first, let's minimize this window. Great. Also, let's come out from the SQL prompt. Let's clear the screen as well. Done. Okay. In Oracle Database Server, usually listener takes care of domain and port number. You can use it to find out the desired information. You simply have to combine the Oracle command with the Windows shell command, like this. This is the Oracle command. On execution, this command will show you the status of your listener. In the heap of text, which this command will show you on execution, we will have to find out the value for host parameter. We can simplify this process by combining it with another command of Windows shell, which is findstr. In case of Linux, it will be grep. So let's do that. On execution, this will show you all the statements containing the values for host from your listener. Let's see. Here we go. As you can see, I have quite a few statements containing string host. Once you have your port number figured out, then finding the host name won't be that tough. For example, in our case, the port number was 5500. Now we have to find out the host name corresponding to the port number 5500. And here it is.
See how easy it is. So that's how we can find the correct URL for Oracle Enterprise Manager Database Express or OEM Express. Hope you will find this video helpful. If so, then please hit the thumbs up button and like this video. And share this video with your friends on your social media. Most importantly, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Also, press the bell icon to get notified every time I upload a new video. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.